People started talking about the Antikythera mechanism as a computer back in the 1950s when the word was sort of in transition. Before that time, computer meant really any kind of calculating device. And now we've come to think of it as meaning particularly electronic, programmable, digital devices. Now, the Antikythera mechanism was definitely not electronic, programmable, or digital. It's a geared device that's designed to solve certain kinds of problems or demonstrate certain kinds of scientific and cultural effects. And it is what we would call an analog computer, if you want to call it that at all. It shows things in a spatial way, as movements and as distances on dials, not as numbers. I prefer to think of it more as a kind of a demonstration device rather than a calculator, because I think it wasn't meant so much to yield data, but to show how things in the world work in a condition that is easier to show on a device than in the real sky. First heard about the Antikythera mechanism when I was a university student, and it was a mathematics professor who was a very widely read person who happened to have seen the first really significant publication that used x-rays to try to see the structure of the surviving pieces. But I didn't follow that up at the time. I got interested in history of science a little bit later, and particularly history of early astronomy. And people knew about this thing. But at that time, they didn't think that the astronomy in it was very advanced. They thought that it was something very clever mechanically, but that it was doing rather simple things to do just with cycles of calendars and so on. We now know it's much more complicated than that. It's showing movements of planets back and forth in the zodiacs and very sophisticated things, sophisticated scientifically as well as technically. So it's only since 2006 or so that I've really been deeply involved with this thing as something that is really worth looking into more deeply.